thought I'd read it because it's got a priest in it, so. September 30th. Sorry for silence. Crazy thing happened this week. Monday, Todd Grassberger died. Future readers know Todd, have I mentioned? Probably not mentioned. Todd, not a close friend, just work colleague. Todd and I had a running joke I had never returned firewire I had borrowed. In fact, it was company firewire, not his. He knew. I knew he knew. It was just our joke. Day started out fine, beautiful Indian summer day. Fire drill in the morning. Whole complex emptied into outdoor courtyard. Day so beautiful, no one minded. Everyone lounging on berms, urging caution. Fun to see people of different companies, like seeing members of different tribes. Navromax equal nerds. Calculating temperature needed to destroy, by fire, entire complex. Orged equal design firm. Has many hippies. Prettier girls. Many orged folks lying on backs on berms, looking up at clouds. One guy playing small wood flute. When all clear sounded, everyone booed, all filed sadly back inside. Then at 2, word rippled through office, Todd dead. Had heart attack at dry cleaner just now, very much. All afternoon, no one working. Everyone stunned, milling around, trying to process the fact that Todd equal dead. Under Todd's desk, pair of hiking boots, against one wall, walking stick Todd used to take on lunchtime walks in the woods. Weird sun shower around 3. Linda Burney, it's like a final goodbye from Todd. Linda equal nut. Once claimed Crow on the ledge was reincarnation of her dead husband. Said she could tell by the way Crow's head was cocked disapprovingly that large mush she was eating. Then storm over, parking lot listening. All evening, found myself looking afresh at Pam, kids, everything suddenly precious. Said prayer before dinner. Do not usually pray before dinner, but tonight, held hands, prayed. Prayed we would be grateful for our good fortune, grateful for each other. Prayed we would remember the various ups, downs, we may experience as family equal small bumps in the road compared with this. Prayed for Todd, prayed for Todd's family. Just nights ago, Todd was in his own house doing whatever Todd did at night. Taking change out of pockets, having laughs with kids, petting dog, thinking of future, tossing dirty clothes in hamper. Where is Todd tonight? October 1st. Todd Grassberger funeral today at Ukrainian Church downtown. Todd apparently from humble roots. Priest equal long-haired guy in cassock. Sings, chants, whole service in Ukrainian from memory. As he chants, paces, cassock rope swings. Scary guy. Very intense. Sermon. Why this surprising? Did you think you were going to live forever? Only difference between you sitting there anticipating the rest of your day and Todd in coffin, bound for eternal home in cold earth, is heartbeat. Feel that, people? In your chest? That is thin line between you and grave. So why do you live like you are eternal? That's foolish. You are fools. This is scary? This is not scary. This is truth. This reality shouts, shall we wake up? Shall we? Everyone's staring big-eyed at priest. Except usual congregants who seem to have heard all before. Priest goes on, which of us will die tonight? Do we think he's being facetious? That shows we are ghosts. Any one of us could die tonight. Die right now. Suddenly come up short of breath, keel over in pew, be with Todd and Earth in wink of eye. Suddenly from downstairs kitchen, smell of roast beef. Happy chatter from church ladies down in the kitchen. Smell of roast beef plus sound of pots clinking, plates being set out, equal appealing. People shifting in pews due to amazing smell of beef. Todd's two brothers come to lecture and make tributes. Older brother, Todd, sweet. Todd, funny. Todd, a powerful force in his life. We'll never forget wonder that was Todd. Younger brother, yes, Todd's super strong person. Todd equal bull. Although Todd can be somewhat firm, Todd did younger brother much good in the long run. By teaching him how to stand up for himself. That's to say, being pushed around by Todd for an entire childhood, nothing can now phase younger brother. I.e., no bull in the outside world will ever be equal of Todd. But Todd's so great. Todd the best. Todd so smart. So good looking. No wonder Todd's mom plus dad always treated him, younger brother, like afterthought. But Todd, so caring, so perceptive, Todd understood this. Would sometimes console younger brother by saying that he, younger brother, was perfectly fine in own way. Often, just before breaking pack, they had made Wednesday night being younger brother's night to borrow dad's car. Thereby ruining younger brother's chance to see a girl he really liked. Possible love of life. Girl he eventually lost to some dope from Stalin. Dope his own older brother, apparently more inclined than Todd, to give his younger brother a decent chance at family car. Todd's younger brother, breathless, pauses at lectern. Can't seem to stop self. Plunges ahead. But Todd great! Todd's so great. Todd will surely be missed. Todd taught everyone in family an important lesson. Although a person might be strong, bellicose, ambitious, slightly blind to needs of others, so that does not mean person not greatest, most amazing brother ever. Who occasionally, as if despite self, might suddenly, surprising all, do some reasonably thoughtful thing. Younger brother, seemingly perplexed by own tribute, then led away from the lectern by scowling older brother, hissing something in undertone. Todd's widow approaches lectern, can't seem to speak. Three little girls clinging to her skirt. Widow hands microphone to smallest girl. Smallest girl, bye daddy. Lunch, good. Lunch, beyond good. Funeral, so sad. Lunch, equal heaven. Eat three roast beef sandwiches in a row off paper plate. Outside, yellow tree blowing in wind. Single yellow leaf blows in through open basement window. Watch it come down, land on my shoe. Think life, beautiful. So glad I'm not dead. If, when I die, do not want to be lonely, want her to remarry, have full life. As long as your husband is a nice guy, gentle guy, religious guy, very caring, plus good to kids. But kids not fooled. Kids prefer dead dad, i.e. me, to religious guy. Pale, boring, religious guy. With no oomph, who wears weird sweaters, and is always a little sad due to cannot get boner, due to physical ailments. Death very much on my mind tonight. Can it be true that I will die? That Pam, kid, will die? It's awful. Why were we put here? So inclined to love, when the end of our story equaled death. That harsh, that cruel, do not like. Note to self, try harder in all things to be a better person.
Thank you.